Well, janitors, this is gonna be one of the hardest videos I ever had to make. Turns out I made a video recently that was called the worst video I've ever seen on YouTube and a pretentious pile of garbage. As you probably already know, I had a take that was met with a fair bit of backlash from the non-subscriber crowd.
I was trying to be funny. I got frustrated and thought I would get some shock laughs. I'm just not that good of a comedian if you want to know the real truth.
You know, I can't even be mad at anyone this pissed off. I guess I should have seen this coming. Not everyone's humor is advanced enough to understand Rick and Morty. While editing the video, I realized leaning into the Rick and Morty stuff might make the video more popular since the fifth season just premiered. What I didn't realize is that it would piss so many people off. Really was supposed to be more of a bait and switch kind of thing. I thought the comments I made about bisexuality would be the controversial stuff, but it turns out that only pissed a few people off. It's when you don't properly attribute the correct sci-fi tropes to its exact origin that really ruffles some feathers. I only had a few hundred people tell me that Rick and Morty ripped off Back to the Future.
This is from Doctor Who. Have you never heard
from Doctor Who?
It was inspired by Doctor Who.
This is from the comics.
The comics came first.
By the way,
the comics came first.
I just want to say thank you to all those people for informing me that the comics came first. I literally was having no idea of this.
It's not like Rick and Morty invented all these ideas or something. I know some of them come from the comics.
Ah, well, it looks like I did know that. And I even said it in the video. Why the hell did everyone tell me that comics came first 100 times then if I said it in the video? Oh, it looks like only 46% of viewers made it that far in the video. You know what? That one's on me, guys. If only 46% of people even made it to the part where I answered the thumbnail, clearly my content isn't exactly gripping some of my viewers. I don't know whether to be trying more or less, to be honest. Still, I feel like maybe I owe you guys a legitimate argument and answer, even if most of the people that complained never watched the actual answer to the question posed by the video, which was kind of. It's the least I could do after riling so many people up with such a controversial take. So let me just say this. After getting taken prisoner through a portal into another world that's presented as a utopia, the main character is interrogated. During this process of interrogation, he escapes and runs from the enforcers. Eventually, our hero tracks down the evil version of himself, but things aren't as straightforward as they may seem. Is Loki a ripoff of Rick and Morty? No! By now we're 5 episodes in, it's clearly its own thing. It's inspired by dozens of other things. I know most of you knew that already. But apparently there's some people out there that think I have to mention the comic show was inspired by comics. If I wrote that sentence into one of my scripts, the next thing I would do would be pick up a gun, trying to make fun of Looper, not become them. I never said Rick and Morty invented portals or invented any of these sci-fi tropes. I'm not watching Doctor Who, guys. Alright, I'm not doing that. Doctor Who sounds fucking terrible. Alright, I'll watch one episode.
I've been mucking around on YouTube. I might be learning useful life skills.
Yos, you don't have to be perfect. You just have to be there.
Wow. Clearly it was a ripoff of Rick and Morty. Now, was the story structure of episode 1 and 2 similar to episode 10 of Rick and Morty? I would say kinda. That's what I was saying in my last video. In fact, that's the only thing I put in the description. Just not a very interesting thumbnail title, if I'm being honest. I actually like this show for the most part, believe it or not. Obviously, Rick and Morty is inspired by Back to the Future, and the Council of Ricks is inspired by Marvel's Council of Reeds. Everything's inspired by something. I can make a video that argues that You, Me, and Dupree is a ripoff of Citizen Kane if I really wanted to. Really, I was just trying to get people to click on my video, and I justified that by all the work I put into it. Do you have any idea how many episodes of New Rockstar's WandaVision Breakdown and Prediction Theory videos I had to watch to make that Mephisto compilation? A lot, all right? Way more than I wanted to. That whole segment took a half a day in itself. I thought maybe when people saw that clip in the first 19 seconds, they would know not to take the video too seriously. But apparently I was wrong. Really, I should be thanking you guys, though, because I learned something today. People don't want you to spend effort and try to make a piece of content on YouTube. No, they just want you to have socially acceptable takes that everyone else has. I shouldn't be spending all this time trying to make content that's an extension of myself, just trying to connect with another human being on the other side of a screen, whether it's cringe or satire, or just me genuinely trying to be honest. I just need to start regurgitating and spitting out what everyone else is saying. Nothing matters in the world anyway, we're all gonna die. I might as well stop trying to be original, just start railing out low-quality videos that have socially acceptable takes so I can actually start making some goddamn money on this app instead of putting out content that I actually enjoy making. Let's start with episode 5 of Rick and Morty. Let's start with the 5th episode of Loki. Richard E. Grant was amazing in episode 5 of Loki. Wow, what a performance. This guy's a really good actor. I like how he dressed up in the old costume from the comics and they had the Thanos copter from the comics. Good job, comics. Everyone knows that was from the comics, right? Please stay tuned for my next video, Top 10 Funniest Star Wars Bloopers. After that, I'll make a Black Widow review where I'll say that it was kind of a mixed bag, had some funny parts, but was overall not a very memorable Marvel movie.